Hey guys, so hopefully everything's working. I just had some free time on this Saturday. Let me straighten this. And last time I did this, I had some issues with the music, so I've got supposedly free music from YouTube's website, and hopefully it'll work out. So today I was gonna work on a Betonator 4000. I've been kind of doing some other things on the Xamarin Android team. So I thought I would try to fix a thing that I encountered last time I did this, which was if you have a C sharp library you're trying to use within Betonator, and it has a jar file dependency, we could include it. In the package Betonator uses. So I haven't really thought about this or looked at it or anything. We're just gonna do it. I can't guarantee that we'll even have anything we can send or a pull request or whatever. So let's just see what happens. The past video is on YouTube. I'll just put it in the chat, but it might have weird audio issues where they muted the music and probably muted me. So here I've cloned Embedinator's source code. And we're gonna see if we can figure out how to make this work. And we'll just go from here. So first let's try to find the code that we'll be wanting to mess with. So this is the right file, actually, compilation. Create AAR. So somewhere in here, we're already doing this a little bit, but jar files and AAR files are just zip files. And they just have so if your package name is like com.xamarin.hey or hello, there'd be a directory called com, and inside it a directory named Xamarin, and a directory named hello. And any compiled Java code's just in there, like it'll be a dot class file. So if you wanted to merge compiled Java code together, you could just like put it all in one big zip, and that's kind of what we're doing. We're doing that with so this is the output. Well, I just wanted to find an example of well, it's probably set of constants. These are the native libs. Oh, it would be in create jar. Sorry. Let's go. So here we're embedding J and A and A. And here
and
we're
here
embedding
we're embedding
on the
Android
monitor with
Android
that
jar.
jar.
So another thing we need to do here
is
include
any other
any
jars,
jars
that happen
to be
around.
Around.
And so let's run Embedinator. Let's just do make sure everything's working. This is just an example command to make sure everything's good. I haven't messed with this, so I'll see. This is just compiling Embedinator. Do I have anything open that make this slow? See. We're good. This is slow. I don't know. Not streaming. Don't have VMware open. So what we're gonna do is run Embedinator on a Xamarin.Forms app and look at the output and see if we can make something happen. Why is it slow? What's going on? Let's see if I'm looking at activity monitor. Oh, OBS. It's doing everything. So, because I'm streaming, I guess. Yeah. Well, that makes sense. Oh, wait. It's done. I did scroll. Okay. Alright, so. If we go into build lib release, we have mono embedded in her. And then I should have brand new Java platform Android-C output. Let's just put it into a test directory. And let's do, I should have this checked out already. It's like called build something. Weather app. Let's do the release. All right. Droid DLL? Let's see what it does. Hey, it looks like it's working. Last time I did this, the release one failed, and I think I actually fixed the issue after that. So, I feel like I'm in an elevator right now. I wonder if anyone's watching. Okay, it's done. So let's look in, let's just look what's in this directory. We're looking for jar files. Okay. So what we could do is just do a recursive directory search in this object folder. And any jar, unzip them into the AR file. Let's see if we can do that. So we only do this on Android. So we're going to look for other jar file dependencies in the users from the users assemblies. So we're going to do so Xamarin Android build intermediate dir. Let's go look at that. It's just object. Okay. Well, it's good to use that constant. So what we're gonna do is for each var jar in directory get files path combine output. Oh, is it called output? We might have a dir up here. Have a variable. I just use an output dir. Options. Output dir. All right. Anything in under object with the search pattern start at jar. And we want search all. So this is for each. Doesn't like the word jar here. This jar's used up. This does need refactor. It's a big method. It looks even bigger when your font size is enormous. But let's just get it working, and then maybe we'll take a look at that. I need a parenthesis. Let's call it dependency. So this is for each jar file. Let's just, so we know if it's doing anything, we can do diag warning file. So we got some code we can copy paste here. This looks beautiful. Look at this. So we can do this. Yeah, so I wonder if I could, we'll refactor. Maybe I could do, okay. So we're gonna open the dependency. All right. So we're gonna open the jar file, and then we're doing a for each on each entry in it. It is just a zip file, so that's why we're using zip archive. We skip this meta-inf stuff because we don't need that. That's some kind of metadata about the jar file. And then if it's a directory, up here, what's this entry path? Oh, let's just reuse it straight up. Look at this. So yeah, we definitely need to refactor this into a helper method, especially if this code is so identical. Let's get it to work first. So let me just copy this whole thing. Let me read it after. So we're going to go to each jar and extract extra stuff into it. Man, this seems right to me. So let's go to, we don't have a script. We're also in the release. I guess I'm going to just chain a bunch of commands together. Yeah, let's do this. Well, let's go up three directories. And we're going to do, let's just put it in that directory. And we're going to do mono build lib debug mono embedinator gen java platform android -c -o build test. Oh, we also need a build embedinator. So this is, we're gonna build embedinator, delete a directory, run embedinator. You have a script, but whatever. This will be a good thing on hit up and go back and forth. What? Did something break? What? Oh, we forgot something. desktop git. We forgot to include the assembly. I had to figure out where it is. Bin release. There we go. Lots of console output. So we should see our console that's printing. Ah! Okay. So we've got something wrong here. Oh, what? Directory. So it needs to create this directory com Xamarin Forms Platform Android Forms View Group. Okay, this is good because we might have to debug. So why would this one work? Is directory create directory recursive? I don't think. Let's just do a quick Google search. I remember dealing with this before. Recursive. Yeah. So let's just, I guess we put breakpoint. Oh, is it possible that we're not hitting this? And then somehow the file is first? That's weird. Let's see. Let's run a command to see, look in there. Info, build. Hey, music stop. I don't know what it's doing. Oh well. Test object forms view group. Oh, they don't have any directory entries. What? That is weird. I've not seen a jar file like this. Well, this would be a bug if Embedinator encountered a jar file that didn't have a directory entry and only has file entries. See, like, look at, look at, like, I'm trying to think where it is. External Xamarin Android. I'm just trying to find a jar file. Look at it. Okay, so if we looked at zip info and this v7 one. See, like, look, there's a directory entry here before there's a class entry. But the forms view group one is not that way. So we can't even rely on there being directory entries. So here's what we should do. We could do something like that, get directory name, entry path, and then if not, let's copy that code. This is kind of, well, this will be good if I refactor this, we'll get this fix. Let's put a comment, note, not all jar files have directory entries such as forms view group.jar. Alright, so I've saved it. We could just hit up to that mile long command. And you actually my thing's in the corner, so let's just do a clear so you guys can see. Here's the command I'm running again. To build Embedinator, delete a directory. Run Embedinator. I need to remember that my picture's in the right hand corner, and if I'm like doing something over there, just need to remember that. Oh. What? Why did it not work? Well, let's do find build test classes. Well, it didn't create a Xamarin directory. Is my code just not? My code right? Looks right. Well, I guess we're going to have to debug, which is somewhat annoying, but So I'm going to copy paste that command we were running. Hey, good thing it has that path. So if you ever want to debug Embedinator, you can go into under run, and see I've already got something in here, but we're paste over top, and add extra command line arguments. And actually, I'm not sure what if this will work, because I think the shell expands it, so I'm going to put my username right here. And once we do that, I can just hit play, and we'll see what's happening here. Let's put a breakpoint here so I can do the full step through. So this is going to do the same command, but we can debug it in Visual Studio. See, and at the bottom, you can, this is miniature. Can we zoom it? I hit my breakpoint. I just seen if I could zoom this console. It's zooming the code. I guess I can't zoom that console, so. Zoom out. Well, so if you guys can't see that, I'll just, you don't need to read it, but. Alright, so this, we're on formsviewgroup.jar. First entry is, yeah, this seems like it's gonna be right. What? What's wrong with that? It's gonna create that. This directory exists now. Expression evaluator. Wait, what just happened? Oh well. Directory path. The directory exists now. Let me hit undo. So what part is going to break? We're just going to do copy to file stream entry path. Oh, it worked. There's something blowing up later. That seems like it's gonna work too. Oh wait, is this directory different? This looks all good. Maybe it just didn't build or something. Maybe, are we hitting another one? Seems like it went. It worked. I don't get it. What? Maybe I just need. Oh, with that build command, that's what happened. That's always the sound. Oh well. This build command up here, when we're doing this, is building it in release. there is a way to make it not release. It's probably something like -c debug. Let's just try that and see what it does. Yeah, that did it. So see, it says debug now. Alright. Hey, it looks like we're solid. So we're now including any jar file dependencies in the AAR package. But we still need a refactor. So I think if let's send a PR that has two commits, one commit that makes this work, and the second commit is just a refactoring, like maybe we'll make a helper function that unzips a jar file into. a directory. And that way we won't have this mile long code here. So let's make sure it works. Let's look in. Where do we put it? Oh, I put it in build. Okay, test. Okay. Find, build, test, Android, classes. Oh no, it's in classes. Yeah. Yeah. So classes, psychcom, something. Ugh, man, look how much stuff's in here. It's com Xamarin, wasn't it? Yeah. So com Xamarin forms platform. Android forms view group dot class. Com Xamarin forms view group build config dot class. So that is all the Java code in a Xamarin Forms app, or those two class files. So this is a good change to embedder to automatically include this stuff. See, how long have I been streaming? Does it say? Well, I'll finish this. Then I'll be done. So I assume it worked. Wonder if I should add the. Let's open Android Studio. And let's see if it works. Probably have to zoom and stuff. This is not the project we want. This is Embedinator's test project. Is it my? Ah, it's this one. This is the one from last stream. I just left it. So we have weather app droid. Where's the forms? Does this work? Where's that forms view group thing? Let's just hit play and see if it works. I'm sure this is an older AR file or something. Starting the Android emulator. This is why I had to have music, otherwise. Yeah. So, it's just not silence or me having to make up sounds. Anyway. I wish you could just listen to whatever music. I don't know. Like, I don't intend to make money off this, so why can't I play whatever music I want, you know? I'm not gonna be had ads going. Okay, it says installing APK. Okay, so I don't know what this is, what this project is. It has this missing. top. We could just make a new project. That'd take a while, though. Well, what is the one that I used? Android Studio Projects. I would have called it Forms Embedded. Maybe test my application. We could just make a new project. Let's do that. Oh, wait. Did I put it? I put it in a Git repo. Embedded managed demo. Oh yeah, Twitch Embeddinator, Android Studio. Yeah, that's. I just found it. It's in. Open and existing. And this is the one we did. I did on stream. Just make sure I don't have like a bunch of apps installed or something. Oh, that's loading. On this computer, you can see the word embed is overloaded. What? I want to install it. Why is this going so slow? I'm streaming and opening a project at the same time. Did I click the button twice? Okay. All right, let's hit play on this one and look at this one. I think this is the one we should mess with because it's got this Forms View Group project. I think we should try to remove it and then copy the AR file we made over top and then just see if it works. It's gonna take a while to build. Let's look at what our change is in GitHub. It should just be that one little paragraph. Yeah. I feel like we should take a method, make a method that's like, you give it a jar file, and you give it a directory, like this classister, and it runs this code. But we'll do that on the second commit. Oh, where are we? I don't know that we'll be changing any code in here, but I'll zoom it in a little. Still building. What? This happened last time I did this. Am I even in the shot anymore? I see my forehead. No, you see me. This is my relaxed position. Listen to free music Saturday afternoon in Kentucky. It's kind of hot out there. My son stayed the night at his grandparents. He's only three. Last night, and it's the first time he's done that. And so he went to bed for a nap at noon, and it is 4 p.m. He only slept, we think, 6 hours. So we need to wake him up in a minute when I'm done with this stream. Or maybe he'll wake up. Who knows? Hey! Something's happening. But I thought this would be good. I'm still testing, figuring out the sound. Maybe I'd send a commit. Oh, where's the top bar? What is going on? There was a button up here that you could click. Like, I'm sure this thing works. Yeah. But there was, like... would break that. I'm not gonna have to, like, what I could do maybe is just, is the problem, using the layout that we included. Let's just go look at that layout. We may not get anything done today if I can't even get the project. Is weatherapp.droid. Xamarin main fragment. It's this one. Well, what creates? Okay, so this fragment has the menu, and it's like not going in there. Huh. It's kind of weird. Well, let's just copy the one we have. Build. So we're just gonna copy over top. That AAR file. And remove this. Oh, I think the best way to remove it is to go here. And then hit minus. It's in a very amazing UI. And then we need to remove this dependency. Oh, whoa, whoa. What's it doing? Okay, so we need to completely remove that project, and then we can, like, delete it even. Let's just, like, delete. Okay. It's like, great, it'll fix itself. The music stopped. This build went so quick. Yeah, it didn't. Just rebuild it. I wish this wasn't so slow, and this kind of makes this video boring. We've already written our code. We had to test this once before I could send a PR. I may not send a PR on this stream, I might do it later. But I would like to refactor that method. And this, okay. How did it error? Port Xamarin cannot be resolved. Oh, what happened? Did we break something? Oh, you know what? We should probably build this again in release. I don't know the last time this was even built. Let's see who can build faster. Visual Studio? Oh, I did. Just got lucky. Alright, so I'm gonna run embed editor again. And then copy the AR one more time. Maybe I can just hit play and it'll work. And then maybe we'll get our little menu bar, which I don't understand why it's... to think about this. Maybe... it's interesting if the debug... well, let's just see if it works. I have a theory. I should have built this thing. Should have built the Visual Studio project first, just to make sure it was the latest. Am I actually... wait a second. Okay. I'm like, I have the thing checked out twice. How do you cancel the build? I guess you don't, whatever. Alright, so I need to actually do against the right one. Wow. Twitch. Samurai Forums. Weather app. Weather app. Droid. Bin. And we're doing release. Weather app. Droid. DLL. Alright. He's got a guy hopping at me. What's he saying? It aired. Anyway. So the thing I was wondering is if this link, when we run the linker here, if it's somehow removing the code that's making that. Let me actually pull up the app that I'm trying to embed here. Let's go ahead and start this to build while I... I'm pulling this up, but... So this app here, you see how it has that menu up here? We need that menu before we can get into the Xamarin Forms code. And that's why I'm doing everything I can to... But I think this time we have the right project. And if it doesn't work, maybe I'll put some code that's like... Maybe we could put a button on the screen and click it just to get there. Or I could maybe figure it out. That's another thing I could do. One thing that's interesting is Android Studio. If you update an AAR file, it's like all of a sudden your IntelliSense just disappears. Until you close Android Studio, reopen it. I'm not going to do that. I don't think we'll be typing code where... Did that type? I hope that didn't mess it up. So I spent 5 minutes writing code. spent like 20 minutes waiting on Android Studio. It says it started 2 minutes ago. If it's taken that long, does it mean it's going to work? Like right when I'm about to give up. It's using a motion detection. Yeah. Well, I don't know any zip codes, but my own. Now click it. There it goes. Well, how could we get that? What if we, so, for some reason, this on create options menu isn't working. There's a menu, it's there. If it's in there, well, we could, like, if I change this code, it's gonna take 2 minutes. Again, set has options menu. True. Is this not happening? I could maybe call that. Let's try that. That won't take as long. So here we have a fragment. We can't use var. Oh, I'm just what? I don't know why that was there. So, then fragment set has options. Is that what it was? See, we don't have IntelliSense, so I'm just hoping that this is going to be the right code. Let's just see if that gets the options menu on there. It shouldn't take as long to build because I just changed Java. Yeah, see. The problem is when you change modules and stuff, like, it redoes the whole build. If it got this far, my code's right. So how do you do, like, a timer? Just copy pasting code. Something like this. That would do 10 seconds. Let's option enter. I think it's that. Let's do main fragment. I'll just make this a member variable. If we don't, this is an anonymous function or whatever. It'll complain, hey, it's not final. Oh, we want to put this code in there. And then see how this is gray? It's saying, hey, you can make this a lambda. Sure. Ooh, that looks prettier. Let's do it after 1 second. And if that doesn't make the menu appear, I'm out of ideas. What, is there a, maybe we could call the code that makes it go to the next screen, like, yeah, like I could call this on options item selected. What's an iMenu item? I can make one. not working. It's been a second, right? Let's do something like this. Oh, as a show history method? Whoa, let's just call that. What? Let's export this. We should be able to call this. We're gonna have to wait 2 minutes though. Yeah, let's just do that. Because we want all this code to run. Oh well. So we do need to make sure that that method's there. As soon as this command's done. That way we won't accidentally wait on Android Studio to build forever again. Alright, so if we do cat, so we have a show history method now. We should be able to call that. So back over here. Show history. I don't know why that options menu stopped showing up. I don't think it would be a bug with Embedinator. Maybe it's because of chain. Maybe I need to run his app from the Xamarin project and see. If that's working on his. It could be that we have a theme in this project that's breaking it or something. What do we got? Theme, app theme? Like, maybe I could remove this. What's his theme? He would only have it here. Doesn't have one, so this is still going. Maybe I could try removing some of that. So if this doesn't work, maybe I can try just debugging the app and make sure that this code runs. Would assume that it would run. Since this is taking so long, it's going to compile. song's called Local Elevator. Alright, here we go. It's happening. If it compiled the show history methods there. Okay. Wait a second. So, it all worked. That means my code, my original change, worked. So let's review commit. You may not be able to see this. I'm just gonna do a commit here. Android jar file dependencies are now included in AR files. This fixes a case where embedding a Xamarin Forms app would not include such as forms. I can't type. Forms view group dot jar dependencies. Okay. So I'm gonna commit that and let's refactor and then just, I don't think I can add a unit test for this. That is interesting. Could I do a unit test? I guess I could write a unit test. I'll do that off stream. But if we were gonna add a this method, where would we put it? We've got utils, Xamarin Android. What's in here? This file has a lot of paths. Xamarin Android build runs MS build. Don't really have a good place to put it. Well, maybe this is okay. Maybe we can just put it here. So we have a static method that's like extract jar. So jar classes dir. Takes existing jar file and extracts it to be included. Music stop. Maybe you guys enjoyed the music stopping, but so we should be able to copy paste. Oh, get out of here. What's this? Oh, compilation. So this would be jar. Alright, and then I don't think we actually need to log anything, so Xamarin Android build. Dependency classes. Isn't this much better? That's a lot more beautiful. So this is kind of doing the same thing. That's interesting. Oh, so... this is the same code, but... we need a lambda to skip it. So maybe we could use that, too. Let's go. So if we added a... funk bool, we need to pass in the entry. This is a zip archive entry. These flipped. Yeah, it takes in. Yeah, that makes sense. Entry. Or continue. It is going a little slow because I'm streaming. So this one here would be so this would be var jna jar, and then filter equal options target platform options compilation platform droid. And if it is, it would be this is gonna have you tough to compile. Else, no. It doesn't know what. What's it doing? Oh, it lost its mind. So I might have to put the type here. I put the word var here now. Yeah. Now, I don't know why I can't delete this. There we go. Alright, so this is going to return... needs to return a false if it ends with SO. Okay. So we're going to be doing this. This is so much cleaner. Filter. Yeah, that looks so much better. So we got rid of like 100 lines of code. And hopefully they didn't break anything. So let's just compare the, let me look at the diff of this. So, yeah. So are there any other places that we are doing, making a zip? This has a lot of custom code to figure out the directories they're going in. Yeah, so I think this is the only three places. So there's only three jar files that get extracted, well, three places where jar files. So the JNA, which is used by C generator. Mono Android is used for Xamarin Android. And then any other jars we find. Alright, so let's do. So let's see if that was a test. So did we break anything? We should be able to find that Xamarin Forms. Well, so we're seeing mono Android stuff. Look how much. There's the Xamarin Forms view group. There's JNA. Exclude these. How big are these? What? It's like a megabyte of stuff in there. So there's more JNI native libraries that we need to exclude. We need to skip .a files. JNI lib? Oh, let's write some notes. Well, when you let's do a new note. So we need to get rid of .a files, .jn, what is it? JNI lib files. Yeah, this doesn't need to be in Android, it's in a Darwin directory. DLL files? So I wonder if I should skip directories. Well, let's just skip DLLs also. So .a. Yeah. Okay. That's for later. So far it seems like this commit's good though. Okay, so the other thing ends with SO. So how can we make this code look okay? It doesn't end with A, and it doesn't end with DLL, and it doesn't end with JNILib. Well, we're doing two improvements here. We're excluding stuff from classes.jar. It looks like about maybe a megabyte, which is nice. Assuming this code works. And we're also making it where you don't have to have any workaround to get the Xamarin Forms app to work. So, all right, let's look, see if I did make this better. Center com sun JNA. Yeah. We left some files out. So how big is that? It's now 1.2 megabytes. So how, let's see. So the AR file is 13 megs. I wonder what it was before. I could look at it was in Android Studio projects, and then forms embedded. Okay, so it was 13.9 and now it's 13.3. So it's free space. Go for it. So I think that's all I'm going to do for this stream. And hopefully I can put this on YouTube and they don't think I'm playing copyrighted music. We'll see. We'll see what happens. But, you know, sending a PR for this is probably not as interesting as actually making this work. But what we did today, just to wrap up, we any jar files that are needed by the C# application, we're including in the AR file now. And so the last time I did this with the Xamarin Forms app, I had to manually add forms to group.jar to Android Studio. And now you don't have to do that. So I hope you like my free music. I'll try to find more. It seemed like it repeated like 3 times. But anyway. Thanks, guys.